So much ice on me, I wish I had two necks. I got homies that can sleep without two things. I got homies that can sleep without Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Gon' pop it for me, cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah, drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of I got both my girls, head to toe, designer. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha-cha macho with a rockin' black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, duckin' 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, lil' bro. Let me feel myself a little bit. Let me blow this down a little bit. Drip, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, you ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit.
This for all the ones that doubted me. Gotta lose once to be a true winner. Only want the hundreds with the blues in her. Eating blood across it where the blood dinner. Juice stay turned like, you know. I've been through that water like Olympic swimmers. Only bread and butter what we ate for dinner. So I had to drink it till the dream is bigger. Only want the gold, we don't need the silver. Gotta be number one, number two never count. Used to have bubble guts competition, now pouring them out. Making my babies proud, wanna cop my mama a house. Coming straight out the south, got enough juice to end the drought.
I bought like 23. Won't fall again and I put that on me. Yeah. I feel the way my heart all on my sleeve. That's why I had to put my wrist on freeze. Come follow me, can't take another L. Designer on me, this that new Chanel. Did that splash, did that drill. Yeah, champion, yeah, we here.
My goals, I do not feel ashamed. I'm a dog, I'm a beast, and I cannot be tamed. I don't do it for fame, it's the love for the game. I go in like I'm trained. I'm prepared for the rain, they amazed. I ain't break from the sticks and stones they threw. Anything that you can do, I can do it better than you. No matter what I do, achieve, still got something to prove. I spent the check on the diamond cross, but still ain't paid my dues. Gotta be number one, number two never count. Used to have bubble guts competition, now pouring them out. Making my babies proud, wanna cop my mama a house. Coming straight out the south, got enough juice to end the drought. Yeah,
I bought like 23. Won't fall again, and I put that on me. Yeah, I feel the way my heart all on my sleeve. That's why I had to put my wrist on freeze. Come for the win, can't take another L. Designer on me, this that new Chanel. Did that splash, did that drill. Yeah, yeah, champion, yeah, we here.
and pick it and go.
We just step on, spin moves, and zones, go. From sideline to touchdown, I put on a show.
Natural fly la mama to the moon.
from beautiful South Florida. There's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Las Vegas Raiders and the Miami Dolphins.
To kick off.
Both of these teams about to reach the halfway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. Taken about 7 yards deep, and he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Start this drive in the air. Throw complete right side to Cooks. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. 5 yards on the game's first play. Second down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. 5 yards on first down, but now just a 1 yard pickup there on second.
Third down.
And they'll look to avoid an early three and out here on third and 4. To throw here. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Shaq Lawson, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, that allows your blitzers to get there.
34-yard line.
And the Dolphins now with a first and 10 at the 34. He'll throw from the gun. And that to his running back, Edwards-Helaire. It'll be a gain of 6, and it's a second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
They'll come up on a second and 4 now from the 40-yard line. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. Flush to his right. He'll find Clyde Edwards-Helaire and able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A gain there of 21 yards.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 39-yard line. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. He's airing it out for Williams. And it's intercepted at the goal line. A great read, and it's picked off. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is...
It's a foot race. The 40, 30, the 20. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Josh Jacobs, an even 90 yards. And the Raiders have taken the early lead. So their backs were against the wall, deep back in their own territory, and they run it all the way down into the end zone.
That takes a lot of coordination for an offensive team, doesn't it? Because, let's face it, it's really not a surprise that they're going to run the ball in that situation. Backed up that close to their own end zone, you usually do call running plays, trying to be safe. Instead, it turns into an electrical run, a bolt for your team, and off he goes to the races.
And this carries into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Second and six, just inside the 30.
Let's go, let's go. 22 needle. Mike, number 53. Mike, 53. Here we go, here we go. 36, 36. Check, checkpoint three. Let's go.
Let's go. Tua with a quick throw, caught out wide. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. That one, a first down pickup of eight. If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy, either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes it's just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
Play action, now it's Tua. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40, before being taken down. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
24-yard line.
For the first time with Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Then he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
A three-yard pickup brings up second and seven.
Here's Tua. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds. A good chunk on the ground on the keeper. 17 yards. First down.
At the 4-yard line.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. A great play there. His 11th touchdown of the year. And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7.
Chase McLaughlin set to kick off.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
Set to get this drive started, and they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play action pass could very well be open.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. Now a deep ball here, hauled in just past the 50. Trotty! And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Henry Ruggs. His 2nd touchdown on the season, and the Raiders have taken the lead.
Lining up for the point after.
Seeing some pretty good offense here in this first quarter.
It's been a wild start to this quarter, as you've noted. And now with that lead that we're seeing, can they retaliate? I get the sense this one's going to go back and forth all game long.
And that probably won't be the last long touchdown that we see in this one.
Will Lutz set to kick off.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down. Under a minute to go, clock running and a back-and-forth first quarter of play. On play action, here's Tua. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. Close there. He caught it, just wasn't able to stay in bounds.
And that's where the sideline, it was used as a 12th defender. You know, 11's legal. This one is an imaginary one, one that my college coach used to call Sammy Sideline. Sammy Sideline can protect you at times, and in this case, that's exactly what he did for the defenders.
Flushed out right. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Open receiver, that's Hayden Hurst, the tight end. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. A Miami first down, that one going for a gain of 11. Tua to throw again. To the right side and complete to Hurst. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Given back-to-back catches now. That one for 16. And another first down. Again, it's Tagovailoa. He'll find his running back, Edwards-Helaire. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
And this is just a little touch pass. They send the receiver in motion, just kind of tap it forward to him. Now, it doesn't turn into a huge play, but they do pick up a first down, a nice, consistent gain.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. And the Dolphins are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. The Dolphin passing game rolling here. They've got another first down. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. A great effort there with his second touchdown here this first half. And the Dolphins are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14.
That ties the game at 14. Chase McLaughlin set to kick off.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. We have witnessed touchdowns on back-to-back drives. We'll see if the offense can continue this uptick here.
And I know you're looking at me funny. You're wondering when I'm going to get upset watching these guys go up and down field, aren't you?
I wasn't looking at you. I got something in my eye.
That's the excuse that you always use for something like that. Listen, I appreciate good offensive football as much as the next person when it's played well and is skillful. I'm with it. And right now, this is exciting.
Oh, the defender likes it.
Second and 13. And Waller taking it in over the middle. There he goes, right side. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Darren Waller. His first touchdown on the year. And the Raiders are able to strike quickly for 6. Well, that's a heck of a response to regain the lead after we had seen the touchdown to tie the game.
I would say what we just saw there was a great amount of poise. Because typically when teams tie the game up, it's a little bit of a, how would you say, you kind of take a step back and have to get yourself regrouped. They regrouped in a hurry, didn't they? They attacked back after they'd been tied.
And in a big way, that was a statement long touchdown.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
Touchdown, So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 49-yard line. Too shy of the 30. 18 more yards there and another first down. Boy, an effective play there, getting their wideouts involved in the run game.
What they're always hoping on that type of a play, if they can get to the end of the line and have a chance to turn it upfield as he did there, that means they controlled the blocking and took care of the defensive end or the outside linebacker to give him that lane.
And I guess I need to clarify, I said getting their wideouts involved in the run game, but of course that was actually a pass as he popped it forward. Going to the air, Tagovailoa. Oh, he's got it in wide open, complete. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Now a first and 10 at the 11. Now they try the right side here. And here he'll get it down to the 7. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and 6.
And they give this time to the tailback. And a little bit of space there. Takes it inside the 5 to the 3. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
Makes it 3rd.
And he's going to be swallowed up and taken down. Sacked back at the 5-yard line. Maurice Hurst able to drop him for a loss of 2, and that will bring up 4th down.
Chase McLaughlin on for the field goal.
And his kick is right there. It's good. And that'll bring him back within 4. A good drive gets him inside the 5, but they could not punch it in.
Well, credit the defense, too. Make sure that that happens, because that was the old bend but don't break approach. Made sure they contained them when they absolutely had to and forced the field goal attempt that went through.
The Raiders take over 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and 7.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Check. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Here's the 2nd and 7. He'll find Hines out of the backfield. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. Give him 7 on the play, and that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. This is going to be a Raiders first down as he's got this up to the 35-yard line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10.
5-yard gain on the play. 1st down, Raiders.
They're going to look to throw. That's complete to Hines out of the backfield. It's a gain of 7, and that'll make it a second down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid gain.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. It's caught left side by Cooks. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Throw here on first down. They'll try and set up the screen to Hines. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. An excellent pickup of 20 yards. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Let's go now. 60 Bison.
Just like that. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And that is caught. What a grab at the eight.
Complete
to a nice gain of 21 yards.
First and goal.
Well, we know he has pretty good hands on display there. In fact, he only needed one of them.
Yeah, nowadays, all these receivers work on this, right? They do the one-handed catches off the machine in practice. They do it with their quarterbacks. They do it contested, uncontested. They make it part of their repertoire.
Now a signal and a timeout call as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play.
Second and goal.
Good yardage on first down. Now can they punch it in on second and goal? And that is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. Darren Waller in the final seconds of the first half. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. That is a near-perfect end-of-half drive right there.
And we've seen that many times from the best in the league. But do you really expect to see it done that well by a rookie? And how about the timing? Finishing it almost near the zeros, as you said, right at the end of the half. Great momentum to carry into the locker room.
And that one pushes the lead up to 11.
Makes the score Raiders 28, Dolphins 17.
So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Now problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay. That's going to set him back 5 yards. The delay of game backs him up 5, first and 15. Now a play fake. Here's Tagovailoa. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Grant. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So we have reached halftime here in an 11-point contest. As we go up to Orlando now and hand it over to Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Set to kick off.
The Dolphins down on the scoreboard, but they'll have it first as we get going in this third quarter. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. They'll start out here with a jet sweep. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there, all 11 guys on defense, diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
Second and 6, just inside the 30. Now a handoff looking right. Dancing away at the 35. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
A stiffer challenge now, first and 15 following the delay of game. They'll run here with Edwards-Helaire. And he'll get this up to about the 40.
Good yardage there on first down, exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs, keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Check curls.
Now they try the right side here. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Brings up third and three.
Edwards-Helaire, they'll try to run for it.
Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. Just a 2 yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down. They'll go. It's Edwards-Helaire. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert.
First and 10 at the 50-yard line.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. From midfield, here's Tua. Short throw underneath to Hurst. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Mike, 53. 53. Mike. Come on, D.
They'll run. It's Edwards-Helaire. And he'll take this one down to the 36. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. From the gun, it's Tua. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 21. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs.
Now that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
This one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Tua wants to throw it on second down. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Third down, here's Edwards-Helaire. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Chase McLaughlin on for the field goal.
And his kick is good. And that'll make this an 8-point game. So a decent drive there to start the third quarter. They only salvaged three out of it, but they inch a bit closer.
Yeah, but still lots of time to go in this one. That's why you hear that clapping on the sidelines, right? Hey, got some points. As you said, inching their way back in. Time left to go out and get that victory.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25.
25-yard line.
Offense set to get this drive started. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. A four receiver look here. Three out to the left, one to the right on second and eight. And he fires one incomplete. Darren Waller, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. By the way, I got to apologize because I just realized for about the last four or five plays, I'm eking over into your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm going to get back over to my spot.
Yeah, we're not talking about our on-air commentary here. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual
for
you.
My bad.
Normally, you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm going to try to tighten things up here for this next play. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
Here's Cameron Johnston now as he'll punt it away for the second time. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. This is brought in at the 21. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. 13 yards the tally on the return there. And it'll be Dolphin football. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you gotta like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here. That doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side.
Maybe a little gas,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, a little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield only giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
This a second and seven from the 37. Two are going to throw. Got a throw right sideline is complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That'll be a gain of 15 yards. And the Dolphins are going to get a fresh set of downs. Back now in Miami. It's Dolphin football, but they trail here as we get set for the fourth. 2 and now on first down. He's got his man on the crossing route. Now the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. 40-yard line. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. That's caught over the middle by Hurst. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 16. That one goes for 24 yards.
At the 16-yard line.
So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. And Tua going to keep on the option. And he's going to get it inside the 10 to the 7-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, got to like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Now they try the right side here, and he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a 1st and goal. He's hit pay dirt a lot this year, but not that time.
Yeah, I'm tracking right there with you. You're exactly right. He's found the end zone plenty of times. No way I can find any fault with the call. He may not have scored there, but of course you're going to give it to him.
Touchdown and a 2-point conversion here are musts. And the Miami Dolphins are into the end zone. So the touchdown there, and that play, the tap pass, so simple, Charles, on the face of it, but what makes it so difficult for defenses to stop?
I think it's the precision and the quickness in which the play occurs, because the snap gets to the quarterback. He's essentially playing volleyball with it, just immediately just shoveling it forward. And when that receiver's at a full head of steam, if you don't take the edge away, he's got a chance to get to the corner and get upfield. But if you take the edge away, that's your chance to disrupt that play.
And no disruption there, that's for sure, as it winds up 6 points. And he'll get into the end zone as the 2-point conversion is successful.
Let's go! Chase McLaughlin set to kick off.
So right back to square one, tied at 28 as he kicks it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Offense set to get this drive started. Well, they just gave up the score to tie it. That's the bad news. The good news, plenty of time in this 4th quarter to try to grab that lead back. They go play action here on 1st down. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Raekwon Davis gets him for a loss of 8. What great push up front. Complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on 2nd down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right side. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Many times when a play breaks down and the quarterback's moving around outside of the pocket, you're thinking, just get rid of something short. But a lot of guys are coached, think deep, take the big shot, hoping someone can get lost behind the secondary. They weren't able to connect on that one.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And a throw there going to be incomplete. The defense did their job. Fourth quarter, big stand.
No doubt about it, because the offense has been yelling at it from the sideline. Just do us a favor. Get us the ball back. Give us one more chance to take it downfield. The defense just did them a solid, it appears.
And when they get the ball back, they can kind of play free, tie game. They're not behind. Here's Cameron Johnston now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Now a handoff looking right. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
The Dolphins on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 7. They fake the handoff. Now Tua. And this is going to be intercepted. Desmond King picks it. So how about that for a momentum switch?
We're in the 4th quarter and it's a tie game. You've got to take care of the football here. Now their opportunity to take the lead right out the window, and everything is flipped in the other direction.
Well, we had a number of good games in the afternoon sessions, but this Sunday nighter might top them all. So we come up here on 1st and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Throw complete right side to Cooks. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down.
2nd and 6 at the 38-yard line.
Hines. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
This is 3rd and 2. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. Yeah. They go back to the ground, this time Jacobs. And he is going to have the Raiders first down by about a yard as they're able to convert on third and two. It's getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. A run with Jacobs there on first down, but he'll manage only a yard or two at best. Second down coming up.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jerome Baker. They brought the house that time with a young rookie, maybe a little rattled through the pick.
And you have to be prepared for a lot of pressure as a rookie quarterback because most defensive coordinators are going to test you that way. So when you see that, the ball's got to get out of your hands quickly, and that means your receivers have to understand they have to break off their routes quickly as well.
After the turnover, it's Tua. He's airing it out for Williams. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Back to throw is Tua. He's going to try and go deep again, and that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. These are the spots, this stage of the game, where it pays to have speed on the perimeter, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and in the second quarter, he may very well have run by him, but in this situation, I know as a defender, I'm loosening up a couple of extra steps that allowed him to run with him stride for stride.
Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. They're going for it. Here's Tua with it. It's complete to Grant. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A gain of 12 on 4th and 10, just enough for the conversion. And defensively, an opportunity slips away from the 32 now. Here's 1st and 10. Here's Edwards-Helaire. And only able to get two here, stopped at the 30.
All right, my man, this is now where it's risk-reward. Because on defense, you've got to crowd the line of scrimmage. You've got to get in all the gaps, get up tight on everyone, and try and force the field goal attempt here. You can't let them break one big, but you know something, when you crowd the line of scrimmage, if they do pop one, it's going
to
go a long way.
Yeah, I was going to say, could take it to the house, but the magnitude of this possible upcoming field goal, every yard counts. Now a final chance to stop it here as a timeout comes in with 10 seconds left in the game.
Come on.
to throw is Tua. He'll look underneath here for Edwards-Helaire. Now here's a timeout as they will indeed call it with 5 seconds to go and a chance with a field goal to win the game.
Brings up third and four.
And now this game's going to come down to the right leg of their kicker. Two for two tonight. This will be for the win. And he missed it. That was neither far enough. It wasn't even on target. It's no good, and a costly one there as this game remains tied here in the fourth. So a bit of a weird kick there. That wasn't an overly long attempt, but that never had a chance.
You almost wonder if he might have maybe got that one on the laces because it kind of knuckled on him a bit. And this one winds up in empty possession.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
He'll let this go deep for Ruggs.
And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
Set to kick off.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And they will play it safe here and bring this one out to the 25. Offense set to get this drive started. They're set for their first drive here in overtime, and this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team, and that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and nine from the 26. Now a first throw here in overtime. They'll find Hines out of the backfield. Give him eight on the play, and that'll make it third and one.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
Third and one, trying to keep this drive in overtime going. A big one coming up. Able to find Walter. That's complete. And he is going to have the Raiders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Defense was thinking run, and they're dealt a pass of just under 20 yards. So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 48-yard line. This to Jacobs on the toss right. Trying to turn the corner, but he's going to be stopped right near the line of scrimmage.
Taken down right.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Tried to get the edge there. The defense just too quick to the ball.
That's what we call total team defense there. Can't get to the edge. No place to move it inside, and then allows everyone else to run to the ball and create a big time tackle for no gain for the offense.
That's caught out wide by Cooks, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. It's a first down on a gain of 10. This is a big spot for a rookie QB, and overtime is kind of where you earn your stripes, isn't it?
It really is, and we've talked with enough coaches and players about how these youngsters are getting into the game and playing this at such a high level so early. But overtime, that's an entirely different animal, and he's handling it well.
Yeah, starting to put together a nice drive. 2 minutes left in this overtime session, and still all tied. Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10.
They run it with Jacobs. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. He'll look to throw. That's complete to Hines out of the backfield. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. 11 yards there, first down. Shaping up to be a very efficient opening drive here in overtime.
And can you feel the tension building? Because I'm feeling it, all right? I've got the sweaty palms here with each play because of the enormity of what's going on. Each play means so much in overtime, and they're handling it well as this drive continues.
Here's Jacobs on first and 10. Shedding the tackler and gives him some room. And so close, he gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
They'll run it with Jacobs. And after the good game last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of two there, second down. He's had some big runs in this game, not there though.
But I don't think they're going to be deterred by that play right there. He's had some nice runs in the game. And how many times have we seen a good running back get stopped, yet turn it into something big on a later carry? I'd stay with him.
And he's into the end zone for the touchdown and the game winner. Team. A partner, a great game that we got to see and making it extra special. Not only did I get four quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whip.